Welcome back to my channel. I'm Jessica, and today I have my Advent Calendar Project Pan update. This is a project that was created by Hélène. She is going to be linked down below along with Paula because they've been doing this project together for a few years now. I can't remember exactly when this started. This is the first year that I jumped on it because it looked like such a cool project and I was able to fit it into my schedule. So I jumped onto it, and I'm glad I did because I'm really enjoying this. And I like the whole premise of it. I will have a playlist linked somewhere. I'm not sure where, if I have it down in my description box, where I'll put it up, you know, up there or up there. I don't know. I almost never do my cards. So yeah, hopefully I will remember to do it. Anyway, the idea is to have 24 or 25 products in your advent calendar, so to speak. If you have an old advent calendar that you can reuse, or you could do it randomly like I'm doing it. Some people are drawing like cards, pieces of paper, whatever. I have it on a wheel here, and that's how I'm doing mine, so that it is completely random. I had 25 products that I started with. I keep them in this little bin. That those are the ones I have not drawn yet, so I will be drawing two new ones this month. I had been drawing three, but that will not sustain throughout the rest of the year because I'm actually getting a lot more done than I thought I was going to do. So, you know, that's always a positive thing. And I don't want to end this too early because I'm enjoying it. So, I do have two empties, which I'm going to show you, and then I'm going to show you what is continuing on in this project, and then I will pick two new products and we will go from there. All right, the two empties that I have. This is the Sally Hansen Purifying Wash. It's a pre-treatment cleanser. This is basically a wash that came with, do you remember back in the day when they had those like sugar waxes? Let's see. I cannot remember who else besides Sally Hansen did them. Maybe NADS, I can't remember. And this is from that. I never used it because I just, you know, used regular soap back in the day. So now that is done, I just used it like a regular shower gel. It was fine. Yeah, wasn't anything amazing, wasn't anything bad. Did the job. The other empty is the Kava Moisturizing Lotion. This is the second one I had in this project, and it is now done. And I actually really enjoyed this. I'm trying to remember where I got those. It was a hotel. It might have been a Marriott. Can't remember now, but I really did enjoy that. I have other Kava stuff, and I like everything that I've tried from them. And yeah, I kind of wish I could purchase it, but you know, you got to stay at a hotel for that. And I'm not going anywhere anytime soon, so you know how that goes. All right, the things that are rolling over. One is starting to leak a little bit because it was upside down in my shower. This is the Purity Made Simple face wash, and I was at this purple line last time. Now I am down here. And see, it's starting to leak a little bit right there. That's what happens when it's upside down and right side up and upside down, right side up. Topsy-turvy. The next thing that I have is the Dr. Jart Sick Pear Tiger Grass Color Correcting Treatment. I don't have a ton left in this one. I like this one. I'm not in love with it, but I do like it. It definitely helps with my redness. And this would be done if it paired nicely with my toner pads from Exuviance, which they don't play nice together. So if I am using this, then I don't use my green color corrector. If I'm using my Exuviance toner pads that day, then I use my green color corrector. So I have the redness under control, but I do believe that one is going to be done by the next time. I think both of these will be done. Next, I have this Wild Spirit Rollerball Fragrance and Chill. I have not even touched this except for the initial sniff at the when I brought it in for that update. I'm really working hard to finish a full-size perfume right now, and I don't know if it'll be done by the next update, so I don't know if I'll have any work on Chill, but it is coming soon. It is. I have the Lotion Bar Day at the Spa. A lot of people don't even know what lotion bars are. I love the smell of mint. It's mint and eucalyptus, but I love them. I have excessively dry skin from basically here down, and yeah, I love them. It keeps everything just protected and moisturized. I don't get like crazy dry, when I use those. But I haven't used it because I've been using a body butter that is in a seasonal project that needs to get done first. And the last thing that I'm rolling over is this Lipsyl lip balm. I have not used this at all because I'm working on like 5 or 6 lip balms right now. And this one doesn't have a ton to begin with. It definitely had some usage on it, so I'm not really worried about getting this finished by the end of the year, or December 27th, I think is when this ends. Yes, December 27th. So I'm not really worried about that. I'm not. I do think I'm going to have 2 empties for the next update, though. All right, I have 8 more things in my wheel here, so I'm going to spin. All right, spin little wheel, and we are going to pick 2 new products because, yeah, I need 2 new products. What do we have? Come on. This thing is slow. The Augustinus Bader The Rich Cream, which is right here. Let's remove that one and spin again because I don't want it to pick the same exact thing because I've already used it. Let's see, what is it going to pick for me? Show me! Belief the True Cream Moisturizing Balm. That would be this. I got 2 face moisturizers. It's okay. I can live with that. I'm going to remove that. So we will be down to 6 products for the next update. So they're both deluxe sizes. I don't think these are going to be a problem. I don't think I can have both of them done by the next update, but I think I can definitely get one or the other done. You can see on the Belief, all it is that portion right there. It's not a ton of product. It's pretty skinny. Hopefully you guys can see that. I'm not sure which one I'm going to go for. Probably the Augustinus Bader. It is a little bit smaller. Hair in my face. This one is 7 mls. And does it say what size this one is? I don't see it on here. I'm sure it says somewhere. I'm not seeing it at the moment. And it's tiny. So yeah, I'm probably going to work on this one. So potentially I could have these 3 skincare products done by the next update. I don't think anything else will be done, but 3 out, and I should be bringing in 2 more for the next update. That should be right on par for me. I feel like as long as I have at least 1 empty every month early on in this project, I'm doing good because things are just naturally going to finish up towards the end of the year. I feel pretty good. I have a few things in still that could take a while because I have 2 more fragrances in there. I have a lot of skincare in there. So we'll see. We'll see how it goes. I'm very happy with what I drew this time. I definitely think I'm going to have some empties for you for next update. Definitely go check out Elaine. She is listed down below along with Paula, her cohort in project, I guess you could call her. And I believe she will be doing this again next year. Like I said, this is not the first year it's been done, so I'm kind of expecting it to come back next year. But there's still time if you want to join in. Just pick your products and draw them randomly and start having some fun. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And until I see you on my next video, have a beautiful day.